So given this problem x1, x2, x3, x4, x5, x6, x7, okay, and the probability is given as 0.1, 0.05, 0.04, 0.01, 0.04, 0.06 and 0.7. Find the code words, find the efficiency and redundancy using Huffman coding. Please solve it, give me the answer.
The minimum variance method for Huffman. Find the code words entropy, L average,
so if I arrange it in the terms of the ascending order, descending order, then the order might be like this. With respective probability is written as so these are the probabilities as per the our first step. So now this should be left blank. We'll write the probability once again here. Like that it will go on. So let us do it one by one. So what are the probabilities I can write over here? So here this is the additional part. This is where it will get added up. So this is 0.05. And as we are using the minimum variance, so it will go on top. So your probabilities might look like 0.7, 0.1, 0.06. 0.05, 0.05, 0.04. Let us do one thing. For the time being, since we have just started, Can we use the maximum variance in this case? Just for an example, just we try using the maximum variance because we are doing the minimum variance for the time being. Can we do it for the maximum variance? Just for our own convenience, nothing more than that. So if it is a maximum variance, then we have to put it at the bottom of the existing hierarchy so that the order is maintained. So this can be it. Minimum variance is also can be used. I'm just telling you to do it for maximum variance. Nothing more than that. Because yesterday we did all problems using minimum variance. This is just, we are doing it using maximum variance. Then we again leave out a column of code. Then we go for probabilities. Tell me the entries. Tell me the entries 0.7. Because these two needs to be getting adding up. So that's equal to 0.09, which is less than 1. So basically 0.1, then 0.9. 0.09. Then we have 0.06 and 0.05. So we are keeping the code once again here empty. Then we write the probability once again. Next set, how much? What will be the value? It's 0.11. 0.11 is greater than 0.1. So 0.7, 0.11, 0.10. I'm just writing this as 0.10. 0.09. Then we have another code. Probabilities. What will be the next entry? This will get added up. It's 0.19. As I told you, the one that we are marking is basically the addition or the summed up element, just to make sure that we can trace it back while we are making the code words ready. Then you have another code which is empty. Finally, we add up this two. What will be the answer? 0.3. So your 0.7 remains as it is, 0.3 comes in. And this is our code. Now the same way, so we have reached the end where we have only two elements left in each of in the column, or as if we are having only one element at the upper and the lower half. So we will stop our proceedings out here. Then we will put 0 and 1 alternatively to the higher and the lower probability. So we substitute 0 and 1, we trace it back, 0.3 is generated by here, so it is 1, 1, 0, 1, 0.7 as it is, so it remains 0, 0.19 is generated by these two, so 1, 0, 1, 0, the upper half is 0, so 0, lower half is 1, is 1, so this 0.11 has come from here, so it's 1, 1, 0, 7 as it is remains as 0. Next example, next code, tell me one by one from top to bottom. 0, then 100, yes, 100, 101, next 110, yes, and 11. Understood? Okay, now next code from this. 0, 10, 0.6 is? It's 110. This is where it's repeated. So it is to be there. So 110. 0.5 is this one. So So it's 111. This is generated by 0.9. 0.9 corresponds to 101. So 1010 and 1011. Point? This is 100, I think. Ah, sorry. Yes. Then next, last one, where the final quotes comes in. So it's 0, 100, 110. Check for yourself whether it's correct. 111. Okay, 0.4 is there. 1011. 0.04. Okay, they will have the same thing, I think. 0.4. Okay, this is 10100 and 1010. Oh, sorry. So these are the codes. So basically, we'll only focus on this table, only this portion, the one that has I marked, the left hand three columns, the symbol, the probabilities, and the code words. So these are your code words generated with respect to maximum Huffman coding, maximum variation Huffman coding. If it would have been minimum, the orientation of the new element or the placement of the new element would have been on the top of the tree. Considering the hierarchy is to be maintained. That's what we decided. So, if you know this, can you give me HX and L value, which we will confirm with her, because she has done the problem. I'll also write the answers there. Can you calculate HX for the given set? Anyone? 1.59? You got 1.59? No, HX. 1.6, 1.59 we are writing, bits per symbol. So HX is coming as 1.59 bits, or you can consider 1.6 also. L average, 1.74 bits per symbol. Again, you can check that L average is greater than HX, so the Shannon's theory is also maintained. Can you give me efficiency eta? 91.38. Right? So these are the problems. Now you can observe one thing, why I specifically did this problem. As you can observe, the more the number of symbols we have and more the probabilities are very near approximation, we have the number of steps which or the placement of the probabilities are also very close. So the process of eliminating one after the another becomes a little tedious job when you are having multiple set of elements. So be very careful while doing it. Like in this case, there are 7 symbols. Suppose there are 12 symbols. So the probabilities will be in terms of 0.001 or 0.002, like that. So the addition and new element substitution in the new entry, that becomes crucial. Because each and every step, if you make one mistake, it will go on adding up the mistake. So be very careful. Okay. So in light of that, let us introduce something called as extended Huffman code. So this is a new term. We call this as extended Huffman code. I'm not writing the... Yes. The basic advantage of an Huffman code is we call Huffman code as the optimal code. Because the code that you are generating over here, the third column actually, if you go by the other rules like the Shannon binary or the Shannon Fano coding, you will require more number of bits to represent the same probabilities. Understood? So for example, this 0.01 here, it is 5 bits that is generated. Okay, 5 bits needed. It might be in Shannon Fano or in Shannon binary, you will require more than 5 bits to generate the same. So say naturally, you are saving an amount of bits over here. Okay. So that is what the basic idea is. Ideally, Huffman coding is called an optimal code. So, the new technique that we are looking at is something called as extended Huffman coding, and that comes with a specific element or a specific case. So, we call this as extended Huffman coding. So, what happens usually that when the probability of the number of symbols, the probability of the symbols are very skewed. Do you know what do you mean by skewed? Okay, let me give you an example. For example, suppose you have alphabets. Any doubt with up till now? Why? Noise. So So suppose why we use the extended Huffman code, that's important. So alphabet, suppose you have alphabets like x1, x2 and x3. You have only three symbols or alphabets, whatever you call it. But the probabilities of these alphabets are given as 0.7, 0.15 and 0.15. So that is what we call it, the elements or the probabilities of each of the symbols are very much skewed. The difference is too much. Now if you apply Huffman coding, just do it in 2 minutes. Just do the minimum Huffman coding and solve it. Just take 2 minutes to solve in Huffman coding. Just 3 symbols. Use the minimum variance technique and solve it. Calculate the efficiency. I just need the efficiency. Done? Code words, just tell me the code words. If you arrange 0.17, 0.15 and 0.15, I'm not writing it once again. It's, if I just write it for our own convenience, 0.15, 0.15. So these are the three probabilities given for x1, x2 and x3. Give me the code words. 0, 10, 11. That's correct. And your LKs naturally are 1, 2 and 2. Can you quickly find out the efficiency for this? Okay, so people have already done it. So it's 90.87 is the efficiency. Just keep this efficiency with you for the time being. So using the conventional Huffman technique, we are doing it very fast, but we are getting an efficiency of around 90.87. Now, this extended Huffman coding is a technique where for particular to this type of a scenario where there are symbols having probabilities vastly different from one another, we will use an extension property of entropy. And in that way, we will improve the efficiency. So, let us take an example for it. We'll use this only, but we'll use the extension property. What was the extension property, if you remember? All the possible combinations should be taken into consideration. M1, M2, M2, M1, 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 M2, M2, M3, M3, like that. So, a tabulation can be formed like this. So, second order extension of this. This was one of the properties of entropy actually in the first few classes we discussed. Yes. So, if I do that, so the elements will be x1, 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 x2, x1, x3, x2, x1, x2, 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 x3, x3, x1, x3, x2, x3, x3. So, when there are three elements, these are the possible combinations that we have. What we are going to do is, we will just multiply the respective probabilities. Okay? So, if in order to do that, so x1, x1, what will be the probability? What is the probability of x1? 0.7. So basically you are doing like 0.7 multiplied by 0.7. So it's 0.49. Simple as that. Why we are doing this? Because we are applying the property of an entropy in order to make an effort to improve the efficiency of a source code. That's the only reason. If you ask me why we are doing it, because you will soon find that it will make the things a bit complex. But eventually what we are relying on is to improve the efficiency. Okay. So just formulate the, just fill up the whole of the column. 0.49, then 0.05, then x1, x3, x1, x3, 0.105, x2, x1, 0.02, x2, 0.0225, correct. x2, x3, 0.0. 0.025. X2, X3 is 0.0225, right? X3, X1, 105 once again. X3, X2, 0.0225. X3, 0.0225. This one. X2. 0.025. Oh, I missed the 0. Okay. So, what we have done is, basically using this technique, we have made sure that the probabilities are not that skewed. That it is not like 0.7 and the rest two are lying at 0.15. Now, you can observe that the difference is very small. Now, using this technique, using the minimum variance technique, solve to get the probability. Just do it. I won't do the steps for this particular problem. I'll only expect you to give me the final code words. You do everything because the process will be same. So I'll just write the column for code words. When you are ready, you just tell me.
Because you haven't seen the original one, that's why I have given it to you, because it is a complex problem. You always have a problem in coming back after any problem that you are chasing back is a bit difficult. Okay, I'll give you two more minutes.
Last one, 000111. How many of you didn't get anything out of what I'm talking about here? Except for you who came late. Anyone having doubt with what I'm doing, why we are doing this? Anyone ready with the code? One by one, this is the final code I'm writing, not the entire step, and I'm also not doing the every step. When I'll upload the material, you will find the solution is completely there. So for people who are still stuck with whether the data are correct or not, you can check there. So what are the codes? First of all, it's 1 0 0 0 1. Okay. Fantastic. 010 011. Hey, wait. 011, then 0000. Okay. Then 1 2 3, then 1, double zero or triple zero? Okay. 0 0 0 1 0 1 0 1 1 1 0 1. Okay. Next. 0 0 0 1 1 0 0 0 0 1 1 1. Fantastic. Good. Now you have a scenario where you have the code words. Can you find the efficiency? It looks like a FM channel. How much eta? 98.3. It's radio mirchi. 98.5. Let's see. 98.65 it seems. Answer. So compared to the 90% efficiency, now if you compare with respect to the extended property, although the process involved is difficult, the way you have solved it, it takes time. But if you take efficiency as one of the quality of service in this case, this is far better efficient compared to the existing earlier system. So for specific systems such as this, we will use the extended Huffman property or extended Huffman coding in order to solve. Clear? Fine. Now we are going to another part of it, which is the end of our Huffman coding, the last of the static Huffman coding in this case, and that is called as the non-binary Huffman coding. You remember in Shannon Fano, we did a very similar kind of thing, ternary operator we did. The same way, we have something called as non-binary Huffman coding, where we will use multiple elements. What do you mean by non-binary then? If a binary Huffman coding is adding up the two last elements, here in case of ternary, we will have three elements that will add. But with a twist. Okay, let's see. Anyone having doubt with this numerical earlier one? Most of you, I guess, got the code words correct. The rest is only calculation part. So we call this as non-binary Huffman coding. Now there is a small little rule that you need to follow. Okay? And the rule is, we will use a typical equation which is given by Q equal to R plus R minus 1 multiplied by alpha, where R is equal to 3, depicting the number of symbols. Number of symbols used for coding. This is a ternary operator. So 0, 1, 2, 3 elements we are taking. So R in this case is 3. If it has a quaternary, then R would have been 4. We are not doing it. We are doing it for 3. That is R. We will substitute 3 over here. 3 plus 3 minus 1 alpha, or alpha is equal to q minus 3 by 2. If you ask me why I am taking suddenly this equation, this is nothing to do with Huffman coding, it is only the algorithm for non-binary Huffman coding that we are introducing this. Okay, this is only this analytical expression. Now the rule is, you have to make sure alpha, this variable, is a positive integer without any fraction. Now this is a rule, as you know that the rules and the assumptions depend on the algorithms that you are making. So you have to substitute the value of q such that alpha is always a positive integer, whole number. Now if I substitute q equal to what value of q will give us a positive integer, minimum value of q? Five minus 3 is 2, 2 is 1. Okay, let me give you a direct example. Let us have a symbols as, here Q actually represents a number of symbols. So suppose the Q is having the probabilities as 0.20, 0.18, 0.15, 0.10, 0.08 and 0.05. Q is a set of symbols and these are the respective probabilities of the symbols. So basically Q here represents the total number of symbols which are present. So suppose this is a problem given where you have 7 symbols. Understood? This Q is basically the number of symbols present for our observation. Suppose the given problem has 7 symbols having the respective probabilities. Okay, so you have 7 symbols. Now if you substitute 7 over here, 7 minus 3 by 4 or by 2 is how much? 2. So, or is it how many symbols are there? 1, 2. Should I miss something? 0.22, 0.2, 0.18, 0.15, 0.1, 0.8, 0.... Okay, we have another one, 0.02. Then only the problem will actually hold. So now we have 8 symbols. It's 8 symbols. Because then only I can show you the problem that you are having. So 8 symbols is there. So if you substitute 8 symbols, it's giving 2.5. So the rule is that whenever you are having a fraction after substituting all the symbols, you have to add one more element and a dummy bit. So what we are going to do is we are going to align. So now we have 9 bits. Okay. So instead of 8 symbols, we'll add one dummy bit. Okay. So the alignment will look like this. This is only specific, as I told you, this is only for non-binary. So the tabulation will look something like this. So 0.22, suppose symbol B is 0.20, C is 0.18, 0.15, 0.10, 0.08, 0.08, 0.05, 0.02. So this was what we had. Now we have to add one dummy bit of zero probability. This is the important part. The rest of the things are all same, where you have to add all these three and substitute in the next level. Use the minimum variance once again and form the table. Do you understood what I said? You have 8 symbols. You have to make sure, using the equation, to make sure that alpha as a variable will always be a positive integer. So, since 8 is not giving us a positive integer, we have to add one dummy bit with zero probabilities to the overall symbol. So, that's what we did and we followed off with the same set of calculation because it's a ternary operator, because r is equal to 3, it's a non-binary sequence. So, we are adding the last 3. So, if I write that and we write this probability somewhere here, what will be the values? Maybe I'll write it over here. 0.22. I'll write it here. Okay? 0.22. 0.20. Okay. What is the addition of this point? This is 0.07. Okay. So, 0.2. Then you have 0.18. 0.15, 0.10, 0.08, so that's fine. Now this 3, this is wrong. It should come somewhere over here because it's giving us 0.07. Now you add up this 3 once again. So this will yield 0.25, so it will go on top. So 0.25, 0.22, 0.20, 0.18, 0.15. Now you add up these 3. Which one is missing? Yes. Yes. Okay, I think I have made a mistake here somewhere. If this is 0.8, then change me. Give me the correct answer. what will be the value then? Then I guess this will be 0.8 and this will be 0.07. I think this will be the case, I guess. So the addition will be between these three. What will be the value? 0.32. Sorry? Oh, so this doesn't exist. I think that may be the mistake. This may be the mistake. I think this 0.2 I have redundantly written. I think that is not there. Please check. I don't think I have it here. Yes, only one 0.8 was there. I think I mistook it. So then it's fine. The process what we involve. Whatever it is, you just go ahead. The final, I think I'll take 1 minute. So it is the same. So the values will be 0.25, 0.22, 0.20, 0.18, 0.15. Now these three when gets added up, it's 0.53, 0.25, and 0.22. See here at the end we will only have three elements, unlike to Huffman coding where there was two elements. Correct? Now the thing is the same way in channel final like we did, here we will give 0, 1 and 2. These are the codes. Now 0.53 is generated by these three. So 0, 0, 0. First element is 0, second element is 1, third element is 2. 0.25 and 0.2, they will have a value 1 and 2. And as and when it will go on from left hand side, right hand side to left hand side. Am I clear with what I did? Because the process is same. Process is the same. It's just that you have to arrange it in the order whichever is given. Add up with the three elements. Now suppose it is a quaternary. Then you have to add four elements together at the first instance. So in this case, if it is r equal to 4, then you have to add 0.8 plus 0.5 plus 0.2 plus 0.0. All together, you have to substitute. What is the advantage of using this? What can be the advantage of using this? Less number of steps required to find the optimal code. That is ideally the option. That is the advantage of it. And if you go on calculating it, just finish it off back home. Okay? The efficiency should come around 93% for both. The efficiency would come around 93%. Just finish off the table. I'm not doing it. Just repeat it the same way. 0, 1, 2. Wherever it has been coming up. So, the final code words. Should I write the final code words? The final code words. The final code word should look like this. 2, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 2, 1, 0, 1, 1. 120, 121, and 122. So this will be the overall structuring of it. Okay. So this is all we have for our static Huffman coding or the binary, non-binary, extended Huffman coding. We'll start with something called as adaptive Huffman coding from next day on. Okay. So with that will take some time to adjust. So next day we have your quiz. So coming Monday we'll start with adaptive Huffman. Thank you.